see, for glory to God, he set me free. Goodbye to sin and things that confound. Not of this world shall turn me around. Daily I'm working, I'm praying to, and glory to God, I'm going through. He set me free, yes, he set me free, and he broke the bond of prison for me. I'm glory bound, my Jesus, to see. For glory to God, he set me free.
Amen.
What about Fred's better half back there? You gonna come up, sir?
I'm right.
Well, we'll let you off this time. Who else could come up? praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory.
Thank you, Lord. Yeah.
Bless you, Lord. Help me.
I'm getting to restart.
Thank you.
pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary.
To thank him for. We really been born again. We're gonna go through, we're gonna push, we're gonna make it. Because he said, I'm gonna give you no two, the burden's too hard to bear. And I'm gonna have to keep my mouth shut, I haven't even got a sign.
Brett, I don't have that up here.
I can't find it in the CDs, I looked through it and can't find it.
Do you get up here and sign half time, that's all you have to sign.
Can't get out of here.
No, you got to get up.
Can't get out of here.
Get up. You know, we're supposed to be happy in Jesus, don't you?
That's right.
Amen.
Yes.
Supposed to be happy. You know, I seen people left church sad. They didn't get the soul fed. It was, you know, jealousy, hate, strife. Mighty God. That's a shame, isn't it?
Yes.
The people just got that whole jealous spirit, those hate spirits. That's not a God.
No.
Mighty God. Yeah. Need to get rid of that kind of stuff. Shake it off, mighty God. Amen. And put on Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. If, you know, because he's coming after some people. And I want to be in that number, don't you?
Amen.
I want him to call my name, and I want to be ready.
You ready?
Y'all ready? Judy, get up here.
You can do it.
I'll let you have my mic.
I'll be right there.
Yeah.
one, it's not a soundtrack, but a song right out your storm. I think you've used it once before. It had the background vocals in it. Somebody singing. I'm going to try it.
We can try it, Fred.
Can't be get you home. When the rapture comes.
Okay. Try. Yeah.
Thank you.
You know, always running.
Yeah.
Walk around me, Jesus. Walk around me, Jesus. Walk around. Walk around my bedside, Lord. Before my mama dies, she called me to her bedside. Told me that the Lord has been walking all around. And in the night she closed her eyes, I can hear her singing. Walk around me, Jesus. Walk around. 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 Walk around my bedside, Lord.
With his simple truth. It's just how I go. But I found the peace in the midst of despair when I discovered that God's everywhere. Even the valley is higher ground. Satan can't touch me where God's love abounds. There's not a place where God's hand can't reach down.
So you're going to sing mine? You sing mine, yours too. Amen. Well, I believe Fred's coming to sing us for us. Come on, Fred, sing us.
Let me.
Two or three.
CD in here.
Seven, eight.
Two, one.
Hallelujah. Used to be an old brother and sister, I know.
Listen here.
You have to say it. He's working on the building. I never will forget that song. How many's ever heard that? He's working on the building. Yeah. See, we're the building. He's working on it. One of these days, he's going to get his papers.
Praise the Lord. Amen. We'll try this one for the brother. Amen. Hallelujah. Go ahead, Rich. Bring it down a little bit. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise your holy name, Jesus. The minister had just closed a revival in a huge Midwestern city. Stepped on the train on his way home and found himself seated beside a young man. With nothing better to do, he just tried to start up a conversation. Just something about the weather, just to kind of help the time as they traveled. And he noticed that he didn't receive an answer. He turned to the young man and saw the tears streaming down his cheek. He told him, "Son, I'm a minister. I'm a preacher. I'll be glad to help you any way I can." The young man, through his tears, proceeded to tell this story. He said, "Preacher, 2 years ago, I got so mean and hard that my mom and dad couldn't do anything with me. It wasn't anything but a source of embarrassment for them. Things got so bad, I even went so far as to hit my father one day with my fist.
He told me then, son, I hate to do it. It's going to break your mama's heart. But I'm going to have to ask you to leave this house. Just get away. We don't want to see you anymore. Preacher, I wandered all over this country for the past 2 years. Then about 3 weeks ago, I gave my heart and life to Jesus. Told Mom and Dad what had happened. Told them I'd be on this old train. Told them I was coming home. Preacher said, son, that's all well and good. But how do you know you're going to be welcome? How do you know everything is forgiven? He said, preacher, I told Dad the letter that if everything was all right, they could forgive me of all the pain that I caused them. For them to just hang a little white rag on top of that apple tree, I can see it from this old train, and I know it'd be all right for me to come home. Preacher, would you look out there and tell me what you see? I want to go home so bad. I'm so sorry for all the heartache I caused. Would you look, see if you see one little white rag on top of that tree? With old preacher not knowing what to expect, not knowing the circumstances, just at the window of that old train off and looked out. Turned around and had a big smile on his face. He said, son, you can relax. Said that apple tree's in full blossom. I never seen so many white rags tied on anything in all my life. That's not all. Standing out there under that apple tree, there's Mom and Dad waving a big white bed sheet. Said, come on home, son. Welcome home. And you know, that's just like God. No matter how far in sin we sunk, no matter how we've wasted our lives, all we have to do is say, forgive me of my sin. I want to live for you. And you know, he'll welcome each and every one of us home. Amen. Hallelujah. You know, I'm thankful for his mercy and grace. You know, Brother Bobby, in the church today, we've got so self-righteous. We've got so holier than thou that we're driving people away. Come on now. We forget where we was when God found us. Amen. We forget that miry clay we was stuck in. And once he saves us, cleans us up, gets us on track, somehow we get the mentality that we're better than everybody else. Somehow we get the mentality that we're just all that. But let me tell you something. We're nothing without Jesus. Amen. I believe there's been a lot that's been sweared away from church and the church world today because what people with a self-righteous attitude, the holier-than-thou attitude. Let me tell you something. Glory to God. Jesus came to seek and to save that which was lost. Yes, I believe in preaching against sin. I believe in preaching hell and it hot. Amen. I believe in preaching heaven and it sweet. But let me tell you something. How we, Brother Bobby, we forgot to tell them how to keep from going to hell. We forgot to tell them how to get to heaven. We forgot to tell them, glory to God, if you put your faith, your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, you're going to make it. We forgot to tell them that. We forgot to tell that drunk on the bar stool, we told him how no count he was. We told him how worthless he was. We told him that he's going to hell. But we forgot to tell him that Jesus loves you and he came and died for you at Calvary and shed his blood so that you could be forgiven. Come on! Hallelujah. Come on. We're quick to draw the gun. We're quick to draw the gun and shoot them down. Sister, come on, Sister Mary. We're quick to do that. But we are awful slow to put a hand out and help somebody to get back up to their feet. God, I feel this tonight. Glory to God, we're so slow about extending that hand. Let me help you up, brother. You ain't got to lay in that miry clay. You ain't got to lay in that hog's pen. Let me help you up, brother. We'll get you to Jesus. We'll get you to the Master. We'll get you to the one that can help you. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Years ago, the Lord showed me he didn't want us to be like every other church. He showed me he didn't want me to start a church that was fashioned after every other church on every other street corner. He showed me that he wanted a church open that had their arms open wide to the drunk, had their arms open wide to the drug addict, had their arms open wide to those that's out there in the miry clay out there, sunken down in sin, had their arms open wide to them, brother. Come on now. Oh, but brother, I don't want them in my church. Well, you might as well shut your church doors and go on home. Come on now. Hallelujah. He said if he'd be lifted up, he'd draw all men nigh. Yes, I know he was speaking of the cross. Not know he was speaking of the death of the cross. But if we'll lift him up now, we'll lift up what he done at Calvary. And we'll lift up his precious blood that he shed for each and every living soul. Glory to God, if we'll lift him up, brother, he'll draw all men nigh. Let me tell you something. We can't contain him in four walls. We got people trying to contain God in four walls. We got them trying to put God in a box. You can't put God in a box. God is God. Come on now. He'll choose to move where he chooses to move. If somebody's got a flicker of faith, fire in their heart, he's going to come down and grab a hold of them, brother. Let me tell you something. Glory to God, I've seen him grab a hold of people and they'd be drunker than a skunk, as we like to say. But God grab a hold of them. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, he can do it, folks. He can clean you up. Hallelujah. He can get all the drugs out of your system. He can get all the alcohol out of your system. He can get all the sin out of your life. Come on now, because he's Jesus. Come on. He's Jesus. Hallelujah. We start pointing out, well, I used to run around with that one. Yeah, ain't you glad you're in church? Well, you better watch it. Why? Yeah, I'll watch it. I'll watch God work on them.
Amen.
I'll watch Jesus change them from the inside out. I'll watch Jesus do a work on them. Hallelujah, I'll watch him exalt them from level to level. I'll watch him, glory to God, lift them up higher and higher in his spirit. That's what I'll watch. Hallelujah, I'm not here to pass judgment on no man or no woman. Hallelujah, I'm here to get you to Jesus. Somebody need to hear me tonight. Hallelujah, I was going to preach, but I'm going to read them here in a minute about being healed by his stripes. And let me tell you something, that's more than just the physical healing tonight. How is some of us are sick in our spirit tonight, brother? We got wounded spirits. We got crushed hearts. We got crushed spirits. And we need a healing tonight. We need the master to touch us tonight. Some of us have been shoved away, rejected, and tossed away. And we need a touch tonight. We need to be encouraged. Like some of us has got a heart that's so broken that we don't feel like we can put shown, but we need a touch tonight, and the master's the only one that can do it. I can pray for you. Yeah, I know God hears our prayers, and I will pray for you, but let me tell you, it takes a touch of the master's hand to put things right. It takes a touch of the master's hand to bring healing to us tonight. Come on. By his stripes. I'm going to get one scripture. One scripture tonight. I had more, but I feel like I just need one tonight. Is that all right? Hallelujah. Hey, First Peter, chapter 2, the 24th verse. Who his own self bear our sins in his own body. Woo. My. On the tree, that we being dead to sins should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes ye were healed. Past tense. Why? Because it's done been taken care of. It's done been bought and paid for. At Calvary. One place it says, he who knew no sin became sin. Our sins was placed upon him. No, he didn't become a sinner on the cross, but he bore our punishment. He bore our punishment, our judgment. See, we're so slick to call out judgment on everybody, but brother, we forget that the judgment, our judgment, my judgment, your judgment went on Jesus at Calvary. Come on now. We're so quick to say, oh, God's going to get you. God's going to kill you. God's going to destroy you. Let me tell you something. He took his anger, his wrath out on Jesus at Calvary. Come on. Yeah, we get in sin, we can get in trouble. Because we get the devil legal rights, brother, when we step out from under the blood. Right. Come on. And believe you me, the devil will hit you. Come on. He will hit you. And brother, I know without a doubt, I made the Lord promise I'd serve him to the day that I die. But I believe I had my last chance at that time, brother. And I know, when God forbid, I know if I ever got out from under the blood, he'd hit me and probably kill me. Let me tell you something, but I plan on staying under the blood. Because let me tell you something, that blood that he shed at Calvary was for my past sins, my present sins, and any future sin. Come on now. How? What are you saying? You don't have to repent. Oh yeah, I repent. You got to repent, but the blood's there. Somebody hear me. It's there to take those sins away. Somebody need to hear me tonight. We walk around in condemnation. We condemn one another. The devil condemns us. The devil tells us how worthless we are. The devil tells us that we've done too much for God to love us. We've done too much for God to use us. Then the church world comes along, Brother Bobby, and they tell us how low down we are. They tell us how no count we are. But they tell us that God's not going to use us. Come on!
Oh, but I ain't perfect, preacher. You point me one person out on the face of this earth that's perfect. We're not. We're striving for that mark.
But there's only two, and I say two. Because the Bible said that Job was a perfect and upright man for his time. For his time. But yet he had sinned. There was only one that walked that was perfect without sin. And that's Jesus. That's Jesus. My Sister Mary, I came up from under some. It made you feel like God was sitting on the throne with a ball bat, just waiting for you to slip up so he could hit you with that ball bat, so that he could kill your kids. Come on now. Come on. I walked in such a fear when I was first saved. And it wasn't a reverence fear, but I was afraid. If I slipped, oh, God's going to kill my family. Come on. Anybody ever been there? If I slipped up, oh, God's going to kill my family now. Oh, God's angry at me. He's going to kill my family. You get angry at your children, but you don't kill them. You get angry, you chastise them, you'll correct them. Yes, God will correct us. Come on now. I know I'm going to lose a lot of followers. I'm going to lose a lot of this, but that's fine. Let me tell you something. We serve a good God. My God's good. Somebody need to hear me tonight. And he loves you. He loves you right where you're at. And he will change you right where you're at. No, he don't love sin. Sin is a foul odor to his nostrils. But he loves you.
Get on our high horses, brother. Talk. We're all that. But they sing behind the scenes. They say we ain't all that. If they walked with us day to day, they say we ain't all that. You know what they would say? A frail human being. Trust in a mighty God.
Huh? Because they can't help themselves, brother.
I've felt like I'm going down before. I felt like I couldn't go another step. I know what you're going through, brother. Sister Ann knows what you're doing. We lost our mother maybe 5 years ago in this March, this coming March. Our world fell apart.
Yes.
I don't know about that. I'm sure she did. I went into a dark spot. I still love God with all my heart. I still preach His word. But I questioned Him. I questioned Him. She was the one I went to with any problem. She was the one that prayed. I said, God, who's going to pray for me now? God, why did you take her? I went through all these things. I went through anger. I went through depression. I went through it all. In a dark spot. But then one night he reminded me right when I was going to sleep. And I believe I was asleep when he reminded me. And I woke up. 15 years before that, sitting in the parking lot, they done told her that so much of her lungs had shut down, so much blockage in her heart, they gave her a year to live. Since she'll live a year, then she'll have a heart attack, she'll die if she don't have this and that done.
Mama was a woman of faith. So I'm gonna trust God. I'm not gonna have it done. I was young in the Lord, brother.
Hadn't been saved maybe a couple years.
Daddy hadn't been saved maybe
2 years. If even that, may not even been that long. I said, God, I can't do this. You took Daddy. Are you going to take Mama? I said, you gave Hezekiah. Wait, was Hezekiah king, the king, weren't you?
Yeah, yes.
15 years you added to his life.
Yeah.
Lord, will you please add 15 years to her life? And you know what? He reminded me that's exactly what he had done. Then that broke, brother. That broke. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something. I needed a healing, though. I needed that touch from the Master's hand. It was hard to preach. It was hard to try to help somebody else when you're dying on the inside. But let me tell you something. I found out that Jesus is faithful. It don't matter how low I sunk. It don't matter how much I messed up. I can say, Father, forgive me. I need a helping hand from you, God. I need some strength from you, Lord. I can't do this thing alone. The load's too heavy. The pain's too much. The sorrow's too much. Help me, oh God. Let me tell you something. He's right there, brother. He's right there. It don't matter if it's 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, whatever the time is. He's right there.
Amen.
By His stripes. By His stripes. We were healed. He can touch you tonight. Yes, it hurts. Oh, it hurts. It hurts so much, some of the things that we go through. Losing loved ones. Watching loved ones suffer. Losing friends. Watching people just go through torment. It hurts. But Lord, our brother, if we could just get a hold of the Master's hand and say, Lord, I believe that I've been healed by your stripes. I believe that the Comforter is on the inside. Lord, I know I'm going to make it. I'm here to tell somebody tonight, you're going to make it. You may not feel like you are, but that's the thing about it. It didn't say the just shall live by their feelings, but the just shall live by faith. Hallelujah. We got to have that faith. We got to walk by it, brother. Walk by it, live by that faith. Glory to God, each day we got to get it. So I thank you, Lord, for
for today and the many blessings that you're bringing my way. I thank you for any trial that may be out there, because Lord, you just make me stronger through my trials and through my temptations. Lord, you just help me to become a better person through everything that I face, through everything that I go through. You just help me, Lord, to get closer to you each and every day. Come on! So, I'm going to say this too. Stop beating yourself over past sins that you've done been forgiven for. Stop walking under condemnation. Thank you, Lord. John 3:16, we've heard that all our lives. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish but have everlasting life. But we stop right there, brother. So many preachers will read that scripture. No, stop right there, and they'll preach one of the sweetest sermons you ever heard. They'll preach the cross of Calvary, and they need to be. And that's wonderful, and that's powerful, and that's great. But they forget the next verse. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. They leave that out. Jesus didn't come into the world to condemn the world. But if we refuse to believe, then we're condemned. If we refuse to receive his sacrifice, then we're condemned. Because we chose it, brother.
Yes.
If anybody goes to hell, it's because they chose to go to hell.
Yes, that's right.
Not because they had to. Amen. Because they chose to.
True.
Because he died for all. Every race that we can name on the face of this earth, he died for them. He loves them. Let me tell you something. He don't love the whites more than he does the blacks. He don't love the blacks more than he does the whites. He don't love the Hispanics more than he does this, or the whites more than he does Hispanic, or so forth. He loves us all equal.
Yes, he does.
Yes.
And he died for us all. Hallelujah. See, I want to see a church that goes beyond racial boundaries. I tell you what, Monty Simpson used to come here. He's gone on now. But that brother, he had respect. He called me pastor. It didn't matter who he was in front of or whatever. He called me pastor. He was a black man. And I thank God that we had him here. And I pray the Lord to send more of different races. Whether it's actually only one race, it's a human race. Come on now. We may have different colors of skin, but we all got the same blood. And I can give you scripture on that too. We all got the same blood. And I want to see God bring them in. And I want this to be in Sweetwater to be a church that'll open their hands and arms and them to come in. Listen, I preach to people that's been drunk. I preach to people that's been high. And I ain't never turned them away.
No.
Come on, I'll preach. I might not turn them loose behind the pulpit now. Come on now. Because I believe there is a boundary there. There is a boundary.
Yes.
But they can sit and they can receive that gospel.
Yes.
They can sit, brother, and they can receive that gospel, and it could change me from inside out. Had tent revivals. I love tent revivals. Brother Bobby's tent, man. I love tent. Sister Rebecca's tent lady. Amen. Love tent revivals. I've heard people say, well, the days of tents are just about over. I don't believe that. I believe they're fixing to birth out once again.
Amen.
I believe you're going to start looking, and there's gospel tents set everywhere, brother.
Yeah.
I believe it. You want to know why? And I'm going to tell you why. People are sick of going to church and being condemned and judged and pushed out the doors.
Yeah.
Now go to a tent before they
step into the doors of a church. Yeah. I'm being honest.
Yeah.
I'm just being honest. Now go to a tent. How can you? I've seen it. I've experienced it. I've had tents up. I've had people come in there drunk. I've had people, different ones that have come. I have pull off on the side of the road and they'll sit and listen on the side of the road, listen to the gospel be preached, or pull up and sit in their cars, but yet the gospel was being preached to them. We had revival, 900 Knoxville Avenue up, or had mighty revival. God was moving, the Spirit of God being poured out, and we had some come up. Hey, preacher, we love that music. We love it. We've been listening. We had them big old PB speakers. We was blasting out hollers, wondering they didn't call the law on us. But we praise the Lord. Didn't have no permit either. Just throwed it up. Amen. Hallelujah. Do what you got to do. Hallelujah. They want you to get permits in the city. Hallelujah. And there they come. Hey, we enjoy it. And I said, come on. And, oh, no, we can't. We've been drinking. We've been drinking. I said, come on. You come on. And there's some that got touched that night, Brother Bob. They was squalling. They was crying. Lord touched them. But I could have been the self-righteous. No, I don't want that around me. Won't touch me. That's what you say. I've been to churches. I've been around a while. I've been in them. I've been in one that judge you by what you wear. Your clothes is not fancy enough, not pretty enough. Huh? So you're not good enough to run with them. Is it not right, Brother Bobby?
That's right.
Oh, your wife's got a pair of pants on. Come on.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They'll judge them by that.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Huh? You're wearing a short sleeve shirt. They'll judge you by that. I'm telling you the truth.
Well, I don't see.
But they won't tell you about Jesus.
Yeah.
They tell me how I've not got it all together, brother. They'll even tell you, there's preachers that preach sermons on me.
Mm-hmm.
That's the honest truth. I'm not lying to you. There's preachers that preach sermons about me at their churches. But that's fine. At least they got something to preach on. It'd be better they preach about Jesus, though, wouldn't it? But we've turned so many away. Yeah, I believe in covering our nakedness. I believe, I'm not saying that we shouldn't, but I'm saying it's not about the clothes. They would have thought something when John the Baptist walked in. My goodness, woolly head. Mine. Come out of the wilderness. You know, it didn't smell good either. I'm just being honest. You know, he's rough looking. He preached to them, wouldn't he, brother?
Amen.
They think about me and Bobby, we can pull a preacher rough looking. We've had some meetings, I think, with Bobby.
Yeah, we sure have.
You and Sister Mary did some preaching that tent over on Highway 11 that time.
Mm-hmm.
My goodness, they done some preaching. I still got some videos of that. Yeah, I remember that. They done some preaching. One of the best messages I think I ever heard Bobby preach was in our tent. Such an anointing. Hey, he's getting hungry wanting a tent, ain't he?
Yeah,
praise the Lord. See, he said, he that believeth, you're a believer, he that believeth on him is not condemned.
He that believeth on him, who? On Jesus, is not condemned. It's not condemned.
But he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. See, that's how you condemn when you don't believe on him. But the believer, those that believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, they're not condemned, Sister Linda. They're not walking under condemnation. They're walking in the righteousness of God. Because it's been imputed upon him, brother. Why? Because of Christ. That's the reason we can go boldly before the throne of grace now. That's the reason we can go and make our needs and our requests known. Because of Jesus. Because of Jesus. You mean I can boldly? That's right. Boldly walk it first. Not pridefully, but boldly. Lord, I've got these problems. You're the only one God that can take care of them. And I know, Lord, that you're going to do it.
Yes, it will.
I know you're going to do it. I've seen him pay bills, brother. I didn't know how it was going to get paid, but God done it. Come on now. I've seen him do so many things. I didn't know how he's going to do it, but he done it. I had some things even recently, didn't know how he's going to do it, but he done it. Amen. He done it. Got some things going on right now. Don't know how it's going to happen, but I know this. God is going to do it. Amen. Hallelujah. Why? Because when we choose to be faithful to him, he's faithful anyway. Don't get me wrong. He's always faithful. But when we choose to be faithful to him, brother, he will honor that faithfulness. What do you mean? When they're throwing stones, we keep walking.
Amen.
When they're spitting, we keep walking, Linda. When they're calling us Bible thumpers and everything, we keep walking.
Yes.
We keep walking. Amen. When they get jealous of us in the church, we keep walking.
Right.
Preachers get just old. Don't let me go there. They do. We keep walking.
Amen.
Especially younger preachers, when they start coming up, them old preachers, they get jealous, Brother Bobby. But we keep walking. We keep walking.
Hello.
We keep walking. Why? Because we're walking for Jesus. Hallelujah. So I want everybody to be encouraged tonight.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Danny's getting some good sleep. God bless his soul. He's all right. He knows I love him. Amen. And you keep walking. Keep walking. And when the tempter comes, you just say, listen, Christ done took care of this at Calvary.
Yes.
My trust is in him. You keep walking. When he throws up your past, I don't know who you're talking about. They're dead.
Yes.
The old man's gone. I'm a new creature. You keep walking. You keep walking. And if anybody comes up saying, ain't you the one you said? No. Not me. That ain't me no more. I'm a new creature. I'm a child of the Most High God. Don't let nobody condemn you. And don't you get down and don't you get discouraged and don't you get down in depression because somebody's got a self-righteous spirit on them. You got to realize it's the devil working through them. It's not actually them, but that devil working through them. To try to condemn you. So don't even get angry at them. Get mad at the devil.
Amen.
Put the devil in his place. Amen.
Right.
And pray for them that God will deliver their minds and help them. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Keep walking. Hold your head up high. Somebody's been beat down so much you just feel like you got to walk. And I walked around like that a long time. Preacher said, raise your head up. Hold your head up high. Hold your head up high. I still beat down over there. That's all I'm going to do. I didn't even want to make eye contact with anybody because I figured they're just going to beat me down. I'm being honest. I even catch myself now. Somebody calls me. Oh, Lord, somebody's going to chew me out today. It's been that bad. I'm being honest. It has. But I have to hold my head up, you know. Keep walking. Keep walking. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm fixing to shut up. Anybody need prayer? Come on up.
Several people on
Facebook. Yeah, Brother Bobby wants somebody to stand in for Andy tonight. If one of you ladies would stand in for her, I appreciate it tonight. Amen.
Brother Horace and Mickey.
Horace and Mickey.
And
Angel.
Dee's husband.
Dee's husband. All right. We'll join together here in a moment and pray for each and every one of those requests. If somebody will stand in for Brother Bobby Aiken's wife, Robert, and you ladies stand in for her tonight, amen. And praise the Lord. Then we'll all join together and we'll pray. praying.
Bobby's wife.
Amy. Heavenly Father, we plead the blood of Jesus upon Rachel, Lord, and ask for angels be encamped around her, Lord, we pray. And Lord, we pray now for Amy, Lord. Lord, we just ask that you help her, Lord, in whatever situation. I know she's going through some different things, Lord. I just ask that you'll help her to get her eyes on you, Lord, her mind on you, Lord, her heart on you, Lord, and seek your face concerning everything, Lord. I pray that she'll yield to your spirit, Lord, and be led by you, Lord, in what she should do, Lord, or shouldn't do, Lord. Just touch her, Lord, and do a work, God, in her, I pray. And Lord, I pray for Brother Bobby, Lord, that you touch him, God, and give him peace of mind. Give him peace of heart, Lord. The enemy's been roaring and raging at him, oh God. And I just ask, God, that you'll help him, Lord. Yes. Help him, Lord. Touch his mind. Yes. Touch his heart, Lord. Touch his spirit. Encourage him, God, I pray. In Jesus' precious and sweet name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And what we'll do is we'll join together and pray for the requests on our first off, is anybody else here tonight that need prayer? We'd be glad to pray for you, anoint you a little, and pray for you tonight. And then we'll join together, amen, and pray for all the Facebook requests. Is there, amen?
Well, let's have a pray for my sister. She's been having a lot of problems with the bladder. She's been in the hospital.
Okay. Brother Bobby's sister, too, amen. Is anybody else have a need? Please come on up and let us pray for you tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord. Let's all join our hands together then, and let's pray for the prayer request on the Facebook also. Amen.
Amen.
Got to come stretch, aren't Heavenly Father, we just humbly come before you in the name of Jesus, where we lift every request that Brother Hart, Sister Mickey, Sister Dee's husband, Lord, all those that's made requests, Sister Angel, Lord, everyone that's made requests on our tonight, God, Lord, we ask that you move before them, God, and touch them tonight, God, give them peace of mind, give them peace of heart, Lord, touch their bodies tonight, Lord, bring healing to their bodies, Lord, and lift them up and encourage them, Lord, and strengthen them, Lord, drive back any spirits that's attacking their minds or their lives or their families. Lord, just drive them spirits back, Lord. And Lord, we thank you tonight, Lord, and we glorify you, and we honor you tonight, Lord, and we give you the glory and honor and the praise for everything, Lord. And Lord, we just give you the glory for the service you've given us here tonight, Lord. The presence that we felt here tonight, Lord. The anointing that we felt here tonight. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We praise you, Lord. Jesus, my name.
Jesus,
my name.
Thank you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus, good. Yes, he's seeing good. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
You don't
know,
brother,
friend,
the scripture says,
"Warrant
1,000
flight,
2,000
flight." But just look at it. Amen. It's probably up in the millions. It's just right here. Amen. Put the devil's flight. Through the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 Give the Lord a great big old hand clap of praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's appreciate each and every one. Amen. And let's give God glory tonight. And, okay, yeah. Brother Bob, you care to take the offering. All Sister right. Linda.
Okay.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. Son of God, ask the Lord according to her faith, O God, that you'll touch her back tonight, God, and that you'll heal her. Ask the Lord, you'll take that pain from it, Lord, you'll straighten her spine, Lord. Touch her to give her a miracle this night, God. I pray that she'll come back, Lord, to testify how you can get a whole soul. Testifying how that you touched her. How that you gave her a miracle, Father God.
Yes.
And we give you the glory for it, Lord.
Yes.
We give you the honor for it, Lord.
Yes.
Jesus' mighty name. Jesus' mighty name.
Yes. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Praise you. Go ahead and bless God from the other Father.
Yes. Lord God, we thank you, Lord. We praise you, God. Bless you, Lord. Bless it, Lord God. Let it go forever. That ordinary money will do, Lord God, will go because this has been sanctified to God through prayer, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Lord.
We just thank Jesus for everything. Amen.
Amen.
We praise the Lord's holy and precious name. Amen. And, just shake hands with one another. Hallelujah. May God protect you and keep you and watch over you until we meet again. God bless you.
Yes.
Everyone.
Oh, bless you, Sister Mary.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Bless you.